Hello, this is Dr. Dog, and this video is Outside of Medicine, continuing the book of Ecclesiastes. I have finished chapter 9, part of chapter 9, and finished chapter 8. Just a remind, this is the title of chapter 9, it said Common Destiny for All. Of course, you know what that means. Along with the part of chapter 8, I finished in the previous video. So I'm going to finish the second part of chapter 9. If it is possible, I'll probably start first a couple of verses of chapter 10. So I'm going to read it first. For this is your lot in life and in your toilsome labor under the sun. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with all your might. For in the grave where you are going, there is neither working nor planning, nor knowledge, nor wisdom. I have seen something else under the sun. The race is not to the swift, or the battle to the strong, nor does food come to the wise, or wealth to the brilliant, or favor to the learned. But time and chance happen to them all. Moreover, no man knows when his hour will come. As fish are caught in a cruel net, or birds are taken in the snare, so men are trapped by evil times, and fall unexpectedly upon them. Wisdom better than folly. I also saw under the sun this example of wisdom that greatly impressed me. There was once a small city with only a few people in it, and a powerful king came against it, surrounded and built huge siege works against it. Now there lived the city a man poor but wise, and he saved the city by his wisdom. But nobody remembered that poor man. So I said, wisdom is better than strength, but the poor man's wisdom is despised, and his words are no longer heeded. The quiet words of the wise are more to be heeded than the shouts of the ruler of fools. Wisdom is better than weapon of war, but one sinner destroys much good. Chapter 10. As dead flies give perfume a bad smell, so a little folly outweighs wisdom and honor. The heart of the wise inclines to the right, but the heart of the fool to the left. Even as he walks along the road, the fool lacks sense and shows everyone how stupid he is. If a ruler's anger rises against you, do not leave your post. Calmness can lay great arrows to rest. So this is a part of chapter 10 and the second part of chapter 9. Just to briefly remind, previously talk about what he saw under the sun, which means not really justice. The wicked live longer than expected, and then the righteousness. So it's not necessarily the righteous live a luxury or happy life in the world or long life in the world. So this is, but eventually he said the justice is there, just take time. I think this, like I mentioned, bring the message of hope, even though in the lifetime you cannot see the justice, but still with hope. So and then continue, he said, man, the best from wise man is just eat and drink, enjoy what you have. And then continue, for this is your lot in life, in your toilsome labor under the sun, because this is what you have. This is what is for you, you deserve it. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with your might, for in the grave where you are going, there's neither working nor planning nor knowledge nor wisdom. So in the earthly world, in the world, just do whatever you enjoy to do, do it. Otherwise, when the time comes, the end, you cannot do none of them. Do not leave remorse or regret, I think. I have seen something else under the sun. This is another reality, what he saw. The race is not to the swift or the battle to the strong, which means the winning of the battle doesn't have to be strong. Typical example like David and the giant Goliath. And nor does food come to wise, wealth to the brilliant. So it doesn't mean your talent or wisdom itself can bring the the rich or the food, or favor to the learned, or the knowledge or erudite person doesn't have to have the favor. But the time and the chance happens to them all, because this is probably, a lot of people think this is the time and chance. So that's why they cannot get what they deserve. Moreover, no man knows when his hours will come. As fish are caught in the cruel net, or birds are taken in the snare, so men are trapped by evil times and that fall unexpectedly upon them. So this is means everything in the world, really a lot of time, just the time in this world itself is evil, just trap everybody, but a lot of things looks happening in the random. So this is what he said. Wisdom better than folly. This is another title. I also saw under the sun this example of wisdom that greatly impressed me. There was once a small city with only a few people in it, and a powerful king came against it, surrounded it, and built huge siege works against it. So this is a story he's telling. And now there lived in the city a man poor but wise, and he saved the city by his wisdom. But nobody remembered that poor man, so I said, wisdom is better than strength, but the poor man's wisdom is despised, and his words are no longer heeded. So this means the wisdom, sometimes if fall into the poor man, so that's probably, in his point of view, is not really wisdom, not wise, because the wisdom, like, he was forgotten. I couldn't really get the story of this, the center of this tale he told, but I think probably what he means is the wisdom need to into the right hand, need to be associated with the power, otherwise it's just a waste and will not bring honor. The quiet words of the wise are more to be heeded than the shouts of ruler of fools. So this is saying that the wisdom, if you're really not loud enough, it's worse than, it's not better than the fools of ruler shouting loud. Wisdom is better than weapons of war, but no one sinner destroys much good. So this is wise man can win the war, but destroyed by the fool. Chapter 10, as dead flies give perfume to a bad smell, so a little folly outweighs wisdom and honor. So this is why if you are wise but you do not hold the power, those one dead fish, dead fly will pollute the wisdom, cause trouble, or the wisdom will not bring you any good. The heart of the wise inclines to the right, but the heart of the fool to the left. Even as he walks along the road, the fool's light sense and shows everyone how stupid he is. So this is saying the wisdom, if in the ordinary or silence, is really probably only seen in the left side, too left extreme. If a ruler's anger rises against you, do not leave your post. Calmness can lay great arrows to rest. So this is saying be calm, even though the situation could be really bad, but if the king accuses you, do not leave in a hurry, do not show any fear, just be calm and steady. That will really turn the arrows to the rest. So I'm going to stop here. I hope that you can read, interpret in your own way. Thank you for watching.